Happy Saturday, everybody. Welcome back to Win the Day, brought to you by Back to the Bible. I'm your host, Jacob Wirka, filling in for Pastor Nat. And today, we're going to look at how Jesus is our good shepherd. Have you ever had to work with livestock before? Whether it's sheep or cows or chicken, livestock are not easy to work with. Growing up, my cousins had a lot of different animals on their farm, and I got to help them from time to time. In particular, they had a ton of sheep. Sheep are so needy. My cousins had to do absolutely everything for them, from guiding them, feeding them, providing for them, and protecting them. But why am I talking so much about sheep? Because today, in John chapter 10, Jesus talks a lot about how he is the good shepherd and he keeps his sheep. In this analogy, Jesus' sheep are the ones who follow him. I think this analogy helps us to better understand how Jesus relates to us. Today, I want us to focus on John chapter 10, verses 25 through 30. To set the stage for this passage, it's very important that we note that Jesus has been confronted by a group of men who have asked him to plainly explain whether or not he is the Messiah. And this is Jesus' response. Jesus answered them, "I told you and you do not believe. The works that I do in my Father's name bear witness about me. But you do not believe because you are not among my sheep. My sheep hear my voice, and I know them, and they follow me. I give them eternal life, and they will never perish. And no one will snatch them out of my hand. My Father, who has given them to me, is greater than all. And no one is able to snatch them out of my Father's hands. I and the Father are one." To this point in the Gospel of John, Jesus has already claimed to be the Messiah several different times. Even more importantly than his words are his actions. He's already demonstrated that he is, in fact, the Son of God. To this point in Jesus' ministry, he's already performed many miracles, including changing the water into wine, healing the lame and the blind, feeding the 5,000, and even walking on water. What Jesus is saying in this passage is that if you've already heard all the things that I've taught and seen the miraculous works that I've done and you still don't believe, you're not going to. It's almost as if he's saying, "What else could I possibly do to show you who I am?" So why is it that we don't believe? Jesus says clearly in verse 25 that it's because they are not among his sheep. His sheep are the ones who believe and trust in Jesus as their Lord. Based on this passage, those who believe are the ones who hear God's voice, have a relationship with him, and who are actively following him. If you are trusting in Jesus as your Savior, then you should have confidence that you have eternal life, and this is not something that can be taken from you. Jesus is the one who's looking after you, and he will not let you go, no matter what. There is no one greater than God. No one can take you from his hand. A natural question to ask here is, how do we know if we are God's? As Jesus already said, his sheep are given to him by the Father. And this brings up a more difficult question of what theologians call predestination. Has God predetermined who will be saved and who won't? Now, there are a couple of different ways of looking at this. Some would say that God has already seen into the future and knows who will trust in him. And there are others that say God has given faith to those who would believe before time began. Now, regardless of where you stand on these two positions, I believe the key question is this. Do you believe? Jesus' sheep are the ones who believe in him. They're the ones who hear his voice. They're the ones who follow him. So do you hear Jesus' voice calling you? Do you know his words? Are you trusting in him alone as your good shepherd? If you trust in Jesus as your Savior, then hold on to this truth, that he is never going to let you go. He is the good shepherd, and he will provide for your every spiritual need. And one day, he promises, he will bring you home.